Now we are going to talk about sins, faults, mistakes, errors. In Western culture, the Abrahamic religions are very focused on not making sins against God. In Vedic tradition, the divine and the demonic qualities are always in tension, and this tension creates the universe. There is a mythical story about the devas, the godly beings, and the asuras, the devil beings, demonic beings, churning the cosmic ocean of consciousness and bringing about a lot of new features to the universe. And one of them is Dhanvantari, with the patron, the govern, the saint of Ayurveda, bringing the nectar of immortality, Amrit. So in Vedic conception, the bad and the good are just two sides of just one coin. But in our daily lives, when we lose our connection with God or the divine or the cosmos or the spirit, we start to sorrow. We start to have a lot of inner problems. So this pragya parad usually is translated as one offense, one crime against the divine. But I rather to interpret it as a fault, a sin against the proper understanding between what is permanent, what is divine, and what is impermanent, what is material, what is, in a way, demoniac. It's important to understand that the divine qualities and the material qualities are antagonistic in one sense, and these material behaviors are put as demoniac, devilish. And when we are practicing yoga, meditation, Ayurveda, and any kind of spiritual tradition, we are moving towards to be one with the universe, the divinity, God, or anyhow. But today our Western culture is much focused on material achievements and losing the inner perception, the inner reality, the inner experience. So in this way, by this classification, the Western culture would be demoniac, in a way that it's very materialistic. And material world is going to perish. So, in Vedic tradition, the lower function of Buddhi, of Mercury, is to learn how to do mathematics, learn how to build bridges, learn how to make chemistry, learn how to do all these things that we call sciences. But also Buddhi is an aspect of Mahat, of the bigger intelligence, of the great intelligence, of the fantastic, marvelous intelligence that knows that behind everything there is consciousness. There is a primordial self, there is a primordial divine quality going through matter and in living it. So, the idea here is that all the materialistic things that we do, look to get a car, look to get a husband, wife, partner, looking to have a big house, looking to be promoted and all this stuff, are perishable and are things that are going to change. The things that are not going to change are our soul-related essence. And this is attached with the qualification of saintly, divinely, godly, and positive. Okay? So, the root of any disease is believing that joy, happiness, pleasure is intimately related to material world. If we are not on the proper inner attitude, you can have the best leisure in the world that is not going to be fulfilling, it's not going to be pleasurable. So, in Vedic wisdom, pleasure, happiness, joy, and ultimate sensation of being fulfilled comes from the spirit. And it can also be in the world, like with good food, good this and that, but mainly with the proper inner sensation. If I'm here in the middle of the trees in the forest and I'm just glad about the sound of the birds, is one thing. If I'm here in the middle of the forest angry about the mosquitoes, is another thing. The place is the same, but our mental relation is different. So, Praga Parad here means all the actions that we go through the material world expecting it to be fulfilling. And this sin, this misconception, this fault make us suffer, because in the end the material world is going to change and we are going to be hemmed, we are going to be locked in one desire that was the thing that is should not change, and the things that we don't need here, we don't want here, are coming here, our desires and aversions. But for now, this yogic chat is over. Namaste. If you wanna have online consultations, please contact my email namaste.tiago@gmail.com. Namaste.